The world is filled with different types of people who all practice different types of beliefs. Learning about other people's cultures can make you a better and more well-rounded individual. From tooth filing to Mehndi, here are some bizarre rituals around the world. Number 19, Bayanihan. Usually, when someone is moving out of their home, they rent a truck to take all their belongings with them or some sort of variation of that. In the Philippines, however, they simplify the entire process by just moving the entire house itself. The word bayanihan translates to being in a bayan, bayan being the Filipino word for community. The reason why it's named that is that 15 to 20 members of the community will come together to lift and move their fellow neighbor's house by lifting it up and carrying it to its new location. It's done by lifting from the bamboo poles that are tied underneath the house, which is also made of bamboo. The volunteers are then rewarded with food that the family whose house was moved has prepared. Number 18. Mudras. For those that aren't familiar with the word, the Sanskrit term mudra is defined as being, quote, a symbolic hand gesture used in Hindu and Buddhist ceremonies and statuary and in Indian dance. Mudras can be formed by using either your hands or your entire body, but they are most commonly done by using one's hands. Mudras are also used in yoga along with pranayama, which are breathing exercises that help stimulate the flow of prana, or life force, in the body. Doing so is believed to help channel the life force energy into helping an individual accomplish their specific goals. They are also recognized in regular tantric rituals, where there are exactly 108 mudras used, and can also be seen in certain forms of Asian martial arts. Number 17. Sardine burial. Officially known as El Entierro del Sardina, the burial of the sardine is an atypical ceremony where people in parts of Spain and Latin America do just that, bury a sardine. The following image depicts the ritual and was done sometime between 1812 and 1819. The whole thing is treated as a mock funeral that many people will gather to attend and participate. The sardine, real or fake, is essentially paraded around the streets of the city in its own special coffin, with the town's residents dressing up in traditional black mourning attire. The sardine itself is said to represent the past, while the burial represents the hope for creating a better future, as well as marking the end of the carnival season and ushering in the religious fasting period. Number 16, Krampuslav. Celebrated in certain European countries such as Austria, Bavaria, and the Czech Republic, to name a few, Krampus is depicted as a half-goat, half-demon. He comes to visit the children who have been naughty, while accompanying Saint Nicholas, who, of course, visits the children who have been nice. The Krampuslav is where people come to gather and celebrate the one and only. Just like in the following image, young men will volunteer to dress up in elaborate costumes depicting the frightful figure himself, with Krampus's signature horn, chains, and birch branch. To this day, Krampus remains a very prominent presence in these parts of the world and is so widely recognized that he even has his own holiday greeting cards, cleverly called Krampuskarten or Krampus cards. Number 15, the Naga Panchami Festival. The Naga Panchami Festival is carried out by Hindus spread out through India and Nepal, where they celebrate and worship snakes or serpents. According to the Hindu calendar, the day of worship is on the fifth day of the lunar month of Shravana, which is considered to be July/August. To break down Naga Panchami, Naga means cobra, or simplified to as serpent, and Panchami is the fifth day of the lunar month. On this day, Hindus will worship the snakes at their pits and offer them items such as silver jewelry and milk in order to protect them from evil. The snake deity statues are first bathed in milk, and it's all to commemorate the day Lord Krishna vanquished the serpent Kaliya. Number 14, tooth filing. Carried out on the Indonesian island of Bali, this ritual of tooth filing is performed by a Brahmin priest on both the bride and groom before they are to be married. The belief is that by filing down the canines and incisors, they will be smoothing down the more primitive and savage facet of the soul. This is also considered to be a rite of passage into adulthood and social well-being, as the residents view fang-like teeth on humans as being problematic. Number 13, blubbing brides. Crying at weddings is an odd, as it's a joyous and emotional occasion that marks the joining of two individuals into binding matrimony. However, a custom that is practical in a traditional Chinese wedding states that a woman must purposely cry every day for 1 hour a day, starting the month up until the wedding. After a week, her mother will end up joining her, and then after 2 weeks, so will her grandmother, and lastly, her sister, if she has one. It's supposed to represent the immense feeling of happiness towards the upcoming big day. Number 12, welcome drink. Derived from the roots of the kava plant, kava is a type of drink that is typically consumed in the region of Western Oceania that includes islands such as Samoa, Fiji, and Hawaii. Each culture uses kava differently, as they each have their own traditions, such as in Fiji, where they drink it throughout the day and use it to welcome foreigners with traditional kava ceremonies. It has been described as having the taste of muddy water with a slight bitterness to it. Number 11, the haka. Hailing all the way from New Zealand, the haka is recognized as, quote, a war cry, a war dance, and a challenge to the Maori people. It involves a group rhythmically shouting while accompanying it with intense movements as they stomp their feet in sync. It was done as a way for the Maori's warriors to intimidate their enemies before engaging in battle, but is now more for special occasions or performing arts groups in schools called kapa haka. New Zealand sports teams are to thank for exposing it and making it known throughout the world. Number 10, camel wrestling. Most popular in the Aegean section of Turkey, camel wrestling is carried out in several other parts of the Middle East, as well as in South Asia. The spectacle, originating some 2,400 years ago, pins two male camels against one another after a female in heat has been led past them. The winner is determined as to which camel knocks the other one down first or if one runs away. A winning camel can be sold for up to as much as $20,000. Number 9. Mehndi. Originating in ancient India, Mehndi is a type of body art that uses a natural dye created by crushing up the dried leaves of the henna tree to form a paste known as henna. The most famous application for Mehndi is during the night before a Hindu or Muslim wedding. The bride's hands are covered in intricate designs from front to back, and so are the tops of her feet as well as the groom's. Lemon juice is then squirted onto it after it has hardened and will make the henna stain last longer. Number 8. Witch's Night. Celebrated in various regions of the European hemisphere, Witches' Night takes place on the last day of April and on May 1st, depending on the country. In the Czech Republic, they create enormous raging bonfires that can reach up to 26 feet high, or 8 meters. They once believed that the fire drives away witches. As midnight rolls around, it is custom for young women to be kissed under a cherry tree in bloom, as it is now celebrated as the Day of Those in Love. Number 7. The Polterabend. Taking place in Germany the night before a couple's wedding, the bride and groom will come together with their friends and family to bring luck to their marriage. How is this accomplished? Guests will arrive with lots of porcelain in arms and smash them into the ground. The shards are said to bring luck to the marriage, and the soon-to-be wedded couple must clean them up to signify they must work together through hard times in their new life. Number 6. La Tomatina. Held in the town of Buñol in Spain, La Tomatina is celebrated by the locals and tourists each year. It has its origins dating back all the way to 1945, and the town is essentially engulfed in a giant tomato fight that goes on for an hour. Afterwards, the local fire department will hose down the town's surface, which will be excellently cleaned thanks to the citric acid in tomatoes. Number 5. The Monkey Buffet. Practiced in Lopburi, Thailand, the Monkey Buffet Festival is held at the Pra Prang Sam Yat Temple. Here, the locals provide the province's macaque population of approximately 2,000 of these monkeys with fresh fruits and vegetables. They feast on as much as they can, but are prone to becoming aggressive and stealing from tourists and locals alike. The celebration has been held since 1989 and occurs annually, bringing in many outside tourists to the Kingdom of Thailand. Number 4. The Initiation. An indigenous population of around 13,350 people lives in the Brazilian state of Amazonas, where they practice an extreme form of initiating young boys into warriors. They neutralize bullet ants with a natural sedative so that they can weave them into a glove made with leaves and have the stingers lining the inside. The boys then place their charcoal-coated hands into the gloves once the ants are conscious again for 10 minutes. To complete this rite of passage, they must complete it 20 times over many years. Number 3. Teeth tossing. There are plenty of ways that children around the world celebrate losing their baby teeth, from children putting their teeth under their pillows and waiting for the tooth fairy to bring them money or candy, to throwing them at animals in order to grant them strong new teeth. Not in Greece. The kids, or their mothers, will take the baby teeth and throw them onto the roof of their house and wish for healthy adult teeth while reciting a childhood rhyme. Number 2. Special beads. A South Korean law that was passed in 2000 states that descendants of a relative that has since crossed over must remove their burial site after 60 years. Ever since then, there has been a spike in people that have gone with the alternative form of cremation instead. Now, South Korean citizens are able to use their loved one's ashes to create the beads in the following image. For the equivalence of $900, the ashes can be turned into beautiful beads that are usually kept in special glass containers in the living relative's home. Number 1. El Colacho. found in the Spanish city of Castrillo de Moricia, El Salto de Colacho translates to the devil's jump in English. The traditional holiday involves several men dressing up in red and yellow, devil costumes, and running through the streets of the town. However, while they're running up and down the streets, they must jump over babies that are laid out on mattresses. The children are chosen based on those who were born in the previous year. The week-long festival begins on a Sunday, and the purpose is to cleanse the children of original sin, along with protecting them from evil spirits, sickness, and giving them a safe life.